few of you don't know, we've been going through the life of David.
Niekoľký z vás neviete, prechádzame si život Dávida.
And last week, so we're going through 1 Samuel.
Čiže sme v prvej knihe Samuelovej.
And last week we saw the story where, you know, David had defeated Goliath.
A minulý týždeň sme videli, že Dávid porazil Goliáša.
And he is in this, you know, everyone loves David.
A všetci milujú Dávida.
He's super popular.
Je veľmi populárny.
There's, you know, he goes to a town and the ladies come out and there's like a parade and everyone's saying, you know, Saul has slain his thousands, but David his tens of thousands. David's awesome.
A keď prechádzajú mestom, tak vyjdú všetky tie baby a spievajú o Dávidovi pieseň, že Saul zabil svojich tisíc, ale Dávid svojich 10 000, čiže Dávid je veľmi populárny.
And he goes out into battle and he's always successful.
A vždycky, keď vyjde do akéhokoľvek boja, tak mal úspech.
And he's like a rock star in Israel right now.
A je ako taká roková hviezda v Izraeli.
He can't do anything wrong, it seems.
A zdá sa, že nič nedokáže pobabrať.
And Saul takes notice of this, and we spoke about in great detail last week how he just gets this bitter, jealous, vengeful heart.
A minulý týždeň sme hovorili o tom, ako Saul všetko toto vidí a má také zatrpknuté, pomstichtivé srdce voči Dávidovi.
And he goes on this rampage against David.
A v takej zúrivosti ide a bojuje proti Dávidovi.
And in the end, David goes from being the one that everyone loves to running away.
A z Dávida sa stáva ten, koho všetci milovali, taký utečenec, ktorý proste prchá.
He's running for his life.
A prchá, alebo snaží sa zachrániť si svoj vlastný život.
He's gone from the top to the escapee.
A prešiel vlastne ako keby z toho vrcholu a je z neho utečenec.
His whole world is turned upside down.
Celý ten jeho svet sa prevrátil na ruby.
Saul has burned all the bridges.
Saul mu ako keby spálil všetky mosty.
And he's running for his life.
A Dávid uteká a snaží sa zachrániť si svoj vlastný život.
And the next set of chapters in Samuel are just really about that time of being in exile.
A všetky tieto ďalšie alebo časť týchto kapitol v Samuelovi sú o tom, ako je Dávid vo vyhnanstve.
And it'll go on for years.
A toto vyhnanstvo trvá niekoľko rokov.
Yet what's amazing is if you look at the life of David, he in it all, he's chasing after God's heart.
Ale čo je úžasné, že keď sa pozrieme na srdce Davida, tak sa naháňal stále za srdcom Božím.
He's not perfect.
Nebol dokonalý.
He makes a lot of mistakes along the way.
Veľa chýb spravil na ceste.
But his heart is in the right place.
Ale jeho srdce sa nachádzalo na tom správnom mieste.
And he usually does the right thing.
A väčšinou robí tú správnu vec.
And so it kind of came to my mind is how do we keep that kind of heart?
A ja som sa zamýšľala nad tým, že ako aj my si môžeme udržať takéto srdce.
How does someone do that?
Ako to niekto dokáže?
How do you maintain a right heart that chases after God when there's lots of darkness around you?
Ako si niekto udrží správne srdce alebo dobré srdce v ťažkých chvíľach, keď máš veľa protivenstiev.
Especially when you're in the shadow of someone else's darkness.
A hlavne, ak sa nachádzaš v tieni niečej inej temnoty, niekoho iného temnoty.
Because David wasn't at fault.
Lebo Dávid nerobil tú chybu.
But he's, because of Saul's sin and Saul's jealousy, he's having to run away from everything.
Ale kvôli Saulovej žiarlivosti a kvôli Saulomu hriechu musí Dávid utekať od všetkého.
Maybe you've been in that situation before, you know someone like that.
Alebo možno aj vy ste boli v takejto situácii, alebo poznáte niekoho, kto je v takejto situácii.
Where things are not going well.
Kde veci nevychádzajú dobre.
It's not really their fault.
Nie je to ani ich chyba, tých ľudí.
And many times when we get in those situations, we just get bitter, right? We get angry.
A možno my, keď sa dostávame do takýchto situácií, tak sme takí zatrpknutí a hneváme sa.
And we're going to see in the next few weeks that what David does is he falls back on something.
A tých ďalších pár týždňov si budeme môcť všimnúť, čo David vždycky robil. Že vždycky sa vracal k niečomu podstatnému.
He falls back on experiences that he has, previous experiences he's had with God.
Že vždycky sa vracal k tým zážitkom, ktoré mal s Bohom. Tie zážitky, ktoré mal predtým, ako bol v tých ťažkých situáciách.
And he's going to get into some situations where he's not really going to see God in the situation. He's not going to see where he's supposed to go, but he falls back to what he knows.
A dostáva sa aj do situácií, kde proste nevidí možno Pána Boha v tej konkrétnej situácii, ale vždycky sa vráti k tomu, čo o Bohu vie.
Just like he did when he faced Goliath.
Takisto, ako sa vracal k tomu, keď sa postavil z očí v oči Goliášovi.
Remember, I mean, he's never faced a giant before.
Nikdy predtým sa nemusel takto postaviť proti nejakému obrovi.
But as a shepherd, he had faced lions and bears and other things.
Ale ako pastier musel sa popasovať či už s levom alebo s medveďom.
He remembered how God had helped him then.
A pamätal si, ako mu Pán Boh pomáhal aj v tých situáciách.
And he figured God can help me now.
A prišiel na to, že Pán Boh mu dokáže pomôcť aj teraz v tejto situácii.
And he's always going to keep that thing in front of him, who God is.
A toto mal vždycky ako keby pred očami, kto v skutočnosti Pán Boh je.
Who does he know?
Who
he knows.
Koho on pozná.
And the lesson I take from that.
A čo som si ja z toho zobral?
So what do you do when you're in the dark?
Je, že čo aj ty robíš, keď si v temnote?
When you come home.
Keď prídeš domov.
And it's late.
A je neskoro.
You know, open your door, right?
Otvoríš dvere.
And it's dark in the house, hopefully.
A je tma v tvojom domove.
We'll save electricity, right?
Lebo väčšinou sa snažíme ušetriť elektriku, tak nenecháme right? zasvietené celý deň.
You don't just grope around the house and, you know, find things.
A nechodíš tej tme a nehľadáš tie veci v potme?
You don't fall over stuff.
Neprekoprcaš sa?
Hopefully, right?
Dúfam.
You just turn on the light.
Ale zasvietiš si svetlo.
And that's what we need to do when we're in the darkness.
A to isté musíme aj my robiť, keď sa nachádzame v temnote.
These dark things of life, we just turn on the light.
A keď máme tmavé chvíľky v našom živote, že musíme zasvietiť svetlo.
Invite God in the situation.
Pozvať Pána Boha do tej našej situácie.
And it changes everything.
A toto zmení všetko.
David doesn't fall in all the trials and all the difficulties that Saul has put before him.
A David nepadol vo všetkých tých skúškach a ťažkostiach, ktoré mu Saul pripravil.
He falls back on who he knows.
Ale vždycky sa vracal k tomu, koho poznal.
We have this great verse, set of verses in Hebrews 6.
A máme úžasné verše v Židom, 6. kapitola.
Goes like this, says, we have this hope as an anchor for the soul.
Máme takúto nádej ako kotvu pre našu dušu.
Firm and secure.
Je pevná a bezpečná.
And then the writer identifies who that is. He says it's Jesus.
A potom ten písateľ hovorí, že táto kotva je Ježiš.
Sometimes life is like a storm, right?
A niekedy aj naše životy sú ako burka.
It's not always smooth sailing, right?
Nie je to vždycky taká pekná, pokojná plavba.
It's not always how we want it to be.
Nie je to, aké by sme to chceli mať.
And the scriptures are telling us Jesus is like this anchor.
A písmo nám hovorí, že Pán Ježiš je ako táto kotva.
He's holding us in place in the storm.
On nás udrží na mieste, aj keď okolo nás búri burka.
The waves can beat.
A môžu prichádzať aj vlny.
You might move a little to the side, to this side.
Možno sa trošičku budete hýbať doľava, doprava.
But you're not going to be lost.
Ale nebudete stratení.
You got an anchor.
Lebo máme tú kotvu.
You got an anchor for your soul.
Máme kotvu pre našu dušu.
And it's Jesus.
A je to Pán Ježiš.
David's going to fall back on some experiences.
A Dávid sa vždycky vracia k nejakým zážitkom.
Before he got into all this mess, he was a shepherd.
Predtým, ako sa dostal do tohto celého, tak bol pastierom.
He knew what a shepherd was like.
Vedel, aký je život pastiera.
He knew what it took.
Vedel, čo na to musel obetovať.
And he knew that God was a shepherd for him.
A on vedel, že Pán Boh je jeho pastierom.
In addition, David was also, in addition to being a good shepherd and a good warrior, he was a good poet.
A Dávid nebol len dobrým pastierom a dobrým vodcom, ale bol aj dobrým básnikom.
And many of his poems and his songs come out of great difficulties.
A mnoho z jeho básni, ktoré napísal, pochádzajú z toho času, keď mal ťažkosti.
Where he's in the storm and he just turns his eyes to God.
Kedy sa nachádzal v tej burke a obrátil svoj zrak k Bohu.
He turned on the light.
Ako keby zasvietil to svetlo.
He drops the anchor.
A spustil kotvu.
He invites God into the situation.
Pozval Pána Boha do tej situácie.
And I believe that's kind of what gives him that right heart.
A ja verím, že toto bolo to, prečo mohol mať taký správny postoj.
So this week, instead of going deeper into his story, I want to go deeper into his heart.
Takže tento týždeň, namiesto toho, aby sme pokračovali hlbšie v jeho príbehu, budeme pokračovať hlbšie k jeho srdcu.
We're going to look at a psalm, a song that he wrote. Just like all poets, all songwriters, it when you read, it's a work of art.
A ako každá báseň, alebo ako každá pieseň, je to práca umenia, alebo je tam vyjadrené umenie.
Like a good artist, it reflects something of him.
A ako správny umelec, odráža to niečo aj z neho.
Shows us, reveals his heart.
A poukazuje to na jeho srdce.
But we know it's also scripture.
Ale vieme, že je to aj písmo.
It also reflects the heart of God.
A poukazuje to aj na Božie srdce.
And we're going to look, it's a famous song, a Psalm 23.
Je to veľmi známy žalm, 23.
It's almost one of those psalms we don't even pay attention to anymore.
A je to možno jeden z tých žalmov, ktoré už ani nepočúvame, lebo je až taký známy.
It's just so familiar.
Sorry, I already did that.
But know that this is not only David's song, but it's a spirit song.
Takže nie je to len Dávidov žalm, ale je to aj duchovný žalm.
And it shows how David thinks about God.
Je tam písané o tom, ako Dávid zmýšľa o Bohu.
But it also shows how God wants to be shown off.
Ale takisto sa to hovorí, ako sa Pán Boh chce zjavovať.
Just so we're all on the same page, because maybe it's not familiar for you.
Aby ste všetci boli na tej istej nôte, ako my, možno nepoznáte tento žalm.
So I'm going to read the whole psalm, and then we're going to just go through it, step by step.
Prečítam celý tento žalm, a potom pôjdeme po krôčkoch.
So, Psalm 23, a psalm of David.
23. žalm, žalm Dávidov.
Says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Hospodin je môj pastier, nebudem mať nedostatku. Na pastvách zelených ma pasie, a k vodám osviežujúcim ma privádza. Dušu mi občerstvuje, po spravodlivých cestách vodí ma pre svoje meno. Keby som kráčal hoci temným údolím, nebojím sa zlého, lebo ty si so mnou. Tvoj prúd a tvoja palica ma potešujú. Stôl mi prestieraš pred mojimi protivníkmi. Hlavu mi pomazávaš olejom. Je preplnený kalich môj. Len dobrota a milosť bude ma sprevádzať po všetky dni môjho života a budem bývať v dome Hospodinovom dlhé časy.
Now we don't know exactly when David wrote this.
Nevieme presne, kedy David napísal toto.
We don't know if he wrote it when he was a shepherd.
Nevieme, či to napísal, keď bol pastierom.
If he wrote it when he was in the palace.
Či to napísal, keď bol v paláci.
Maybe he wrote it when he was here on the run.
Možno to napísal vtedy, keď utekal.
I kind of like to think that he knew this beforehand, personally.
A ja si myslím, že on všetko toto poznal už predtým.
Because it's a psalm that brings a lot of comfort. It's brought comfort to millions of people, thousands of people, lots of people over the years.
A roky rokuce tento žalm prinášal miliónom ľudí útechu.
You know, if we didn't know anything about David except for this one psalm, that would have been a legacy for him.
Ak by sme nič iné o Dávidovi nevedeli, len by sme poznali tento jeho žalm, tak toto by bolo to jeho posolstvo, ktoré nám zanechal zo svojho života.
It was a treasure that is given for many for years and years.
Bol to taký poklad, ktoré zanechal pre mnohých.
But let's just look at it in detail.
Ale keď sa pozrieme na to v detailoch.
To see David's heart towards God and God's heart towards him.
Aby sme videli Božie srdce voči Dávidovi a Dávidové srdce voči Bohu.
Says, the Lord is my shepherd.
Je tam napísané, že Hospodin je môj pastier.
Literally translated, the Lord my shepherd. So without the is.
Doslova do písmena, Hospodin môj pastier, bez toho je.
It's like a title or a name.
Je to ako keby to bol titul pri mene.
And it's great that God wanted David to know and wants us to know that he is our shepherd.
A je to úžasné, že Pán Boh chcel, aby Dávid vedel a aby sme aj my vedeli, že on je tým našim pastierom.
It's become such a picture or a metaphor in Christianity, we don't even think about it anymore.
A je to taký obraz alebo metafora kresťanstva, že už sa častokrát nad tým ani nezamýšľame.
But in Israel, a shepherd wasn't necessarily a great position.
Ale v Izraeli pastier nebola vysnívaná pozícia.
You had the king.
Mali ste kráľa.
And then you had the shepherd.
A potom ste mali pastierov.
Shepherds kind of towards the bottom.
A pastieri boli niekde na spodine tej spoločnosti.
Now, I mean, there were a lot of shepherds in Israel, because it's easy to be a shepherd there.
A v Izraeli je veľa pastierov, lebo je jednoduché byť pastierom.
You know, they still have a lot of shepherds there today.
Aj v dnešnej dobe majú veľa pastierov.
But you know, it was the job that you gave someone who's just a servant.
Ale bola to práca, ktorú ste dávali niekomu, kto bol len služobníkom.
Remember, it was David's job.
Bola to Dávidova práca.
He was the youngest of 8 kids, or 8 boys.
Najmladším z 8 chalanov.
You know, it was a job you gave to the one you didn't have a job for, right?
Dali ste to ako prácu niekomu, komu ste nemali akú inú prácu dať.
You know, like, just, we give it to always to the youngest. You just do this, clean this up, or put this away. This is kind of the gopher job.
Niečo, čo dávame aj my v dnešnej dobe tým najmladším, že toto odlož, alebo toto vyčistí.
You know, it doesn't usually require a lot of instruction. Go watch the sheep. Make sure they don't get in trouble.
Nepotrebujete veľa inštrukcií na to, len dávajte pozor na tie ovečky, aby vám niekde neušli, aby sa im nič nestalo.
Now, there's a lot more to it, right?
Nie, ale za tým bolo o mnoho viacej.
But it wasn't considered a very high position.
Ale nebola to považovaná, táto práca nebola považovaná za vysokú pozíciu.
What's great for me is that that's how God wanted himself to be known, though.
Ale čo je úžasné pre mňa je, že Pán Boh chce byť známy takto.
That the creator of the universe, the king of the universe is going to stoop down and be a servant.
Že tvorca vesmíru sa tak poníži, aby mohol byť on služobníkom.
He's going to not rule from this position here, but from down here amongst us.
Že nebude slúžiť z pozície niekde zhora, ale bude slúžiť z pozície tu medzi nami.
Now the shepherd was the provider.
A pastier bol ten, ktorý zabezpečoval veci.
He was the protector of the sheep.
On bol ochranca tých ovečiek.
And he was personal. He had this intimate relationship, right?
A bol osobný, mal taký dôverný vzťah s ovečkami.
And David says it. He says, you're not just any shepherd, you're my shepherd.
A David hovorí, že Hospodine, ty nie si hociaký pastier, ty si môj pastier.
Which puts David in the position of being a sheep, obviously.
Čiže z Davida sa teraz stáva ovečka.
And David knows his heart, his own heart.
David pozná svoje vlastné srdce.
He knows he needs a provider.
On vie, že potrebuje niekoho, kto mu zabezpečí veci.
He needs a protector.
Potrebuje niekoho, kto ho ochráni.
He needs a friend.
Potrebuje priateľa.
But he knows his heart.
Ale pozná aj svoje vlastné srdce.
Sheep, there's a lot of things about sheep.
Je veľa vecí, čo by sme mohli povedať o ovečkách.
Interesting, but we're not going to go here. There's plenty of books about that you can read.
Nebudem všetky menovať, je veľa kníh, ktoré boli napísané o tom.
I'm not a shepherd, so I'm not going to pretend to be one.
Ja nie som pastier, tak sa nebudem tváriť, že som.
But one thing I do know is that they seem to be prone to wander.
Ale jednu vec, čo viem, je, že sú náchylné k tomu, že sa roztratia, roztrusia.
And like us, when we wander,
a ako my, keď sa roztratíme,
they get in trouble.
Tak sa dostávajú do nebezpečenstva.
And David knows that about himself.
A David pozná toto o sebe.
There's this great hymn, I'm not a big hymn person.
A je úžasná hymna, alebo taká stará bylá pieseň.
I should be, because they're great. There's a lot of great hymns.
A nepoznám ich všetky, ale mal by som ich viacej poznať, lebo sú úžasné.
But there's this one that's kind of stuck in my mind and heart since childhood.
Ale jedna sa mi zarila do pamäte od útlho detstva.
And it says this, the chorus says, I'm prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love.
A jedna z týchto piesní hovorí, že ja som náchylný k tomu, aby som sa strácal. Pane, cítim to, cítim, že som náchylný k tomu, aby som odišiel od Boha, ktorého milujem.
Does anyone know that song?
Poznáte tú pesničku?
Okay, good. So, I'm not the only one.
Dobre, takže nie som sám.
But the next part of it says, here's my heart, take and seal it in thy courts above.
Ale tá ďalšia časť tej pesničky je tiež super, že Pane, tu je moje srdce, zober ho a zapečať, zapečať na tvojich dvoranách hore.
So maybe you can relate to David's heart.
Možno aj vy sa viete stotožniť s Dávidovým srdcom.
You know, we're prone to wander.
My sme náchylní k tomu, aby sme sa túlali.
Prone to get off track.
Aby sme odišli z tej správnej cesty.
David needs this shepherd.
Dávid potrebuje tohto pastiera.
Now this shepherd is also personal.
A pastier bol tiež osobným.
The shepherd spends lots and lots of time with the flock.
Lebo pastier trávil veľa času s tým stádočkom.
He knows the sheep.
Poznal všetky tie ovečky.
It's not distant.
Nebolo to nejaké vzdialené.
It's not like in Australia where they have the helicopters over these huge herds.
Nebolo to ako v Austrálii, kde chodí helikoptéra a dáva pozor na všetky tie stáda.
But he's amongst the sheep.
Ale on bol medzi tými ovečkami.
He can identify who is who.
On vie rozoznať, ktorá je ktorá.
Jesus describes himself as the good shepherd.
Pán Ježiš opisuje sám seba ako dobrý pastier.
Says this in John 10.
V Jánovi v 10. kapitole.
Says, I'm the good shepherd.
Ja som dobrý pastier.
I know my sheep.
Ja poznám svoje
and
ovečky.
My sheep know me.
A moje ovečky poznajú mňa.
Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father.
Takisto ako ja poznám Otca a Otec pozná mňa.
I lay down my life for the sheep.
Ja skladám svoj život kvôli mojim ovečkám.
When I was living in Nitro a long, long time ago.
Keď som býval v Nitre dávno, pradávno.
Good friend there, his name's Laci and he works on a farm.
A mal som tam dobrého priateľa Laciho a on pracoval na družstve.
He's a farmer, he knows all about the animals and everything.
Bol taký poľnohospodár, všetko o zvieratách vedel.
And so we went to go visit Laci on the farm one day.
A jedného dňa sme išli Laciho navštíviť na tomto družstve.
And they had a bunch of sheep just out.
A mali tam kopec ovečiek, ktoré behali.
And we thought, oh cool, cute sheep. Let's go see the sheep.
A my sme si mysleli, že je, že milé ovečky, ideme sa na ne pozrieť.
And we go, and we're calling, hey sheepy, you know.
A sme tam išli a sme ich volali, ovečka, poď sem.
Sheep look at us.
Ovečka sa na nás pozrela.
They look around.
Pozreli sa dookola.
They can't find Laci.
Nenašli Laciho.
And they take off running.
A zdrhli.
You know? And they take off running just a little bit.
Trošku odbehli teda, nie ďaleko.
We keep coming to, hey sheep.
A my sme ich chceli pohľadkať, išli sme za nimi.
Trying to pet them or whatever.
A snažili sme sa nejako priblížiť k nim.
Same thing, they take off running.
Zase odbehli.
Laci calls them.
Ale potom príde Laci a zavolá ich a oni prišli k nemu.
Because they know Laci.
Lebo Laci ho poznajú.
Laci takes good care of them.
Laci sa o nich stará.
He talks to them.
Rozpráva sa s nimi.
He gives them the medicine.
On im dáva lieky, keď potrebujú.
He feeds them.
Dáva im jesť.
It works.
A ono to fungovalo.
He's got this relationship with them.
On mal s nimi vzťah.
And that's how God wants to relate with us.
A takýmto istým spôsobom Pán Boh chce mať vzťah s nami.
It's personal.
Je to osobné.
It's not distant.
Nie je to nejaký vzdialený vzťah.
He's not checked out somewhere and he's going to check back in much, much later. David says, that's who God is to me. He's my shepherd.
A toto David hovorí, že týmto je Boh pre mňa. On je môj pastier.
Then he says something that many times we don't say.
A on hovorí niečo, čo my častokrát nehovoríme.
Says, I shall not want. He's my shepherd, so I'm not going to want.
A on je môj pastier, takže nebudem mať nedostatku.
You know, we all have our list. There's lots of things we want.
A my máme tie naše zoznamy všetkého toho, čo chceme.
But literally what this is probably meaning more is I lack nothing.
Ale čo to znamená je, že nič mi nechýba.
We probably still don't relate to that sometimes.
A ešte možno stále sa nevieme na to naviazať.
You know, sometimes we're like, oh yeah, but I would like that, or it wouldn't it be nice to have a little bit more cash.
Ale stále si hovoríme, že a ešte toto by som chcel, alebo viacej financií pre toto.
Or a little bit more of this, or a little bit more of that.
Alebo viacej tohto, viacej tamtoho.
But I think what he's saying.
Ale ja si myslím, čo tu hovorí.
Says, when we're with God.
Keď sme s Bohom.
We have everything we need for that moment.
Máme všetko to, čo potrebujeme práve na tú chvíľu.
I think so many times we believe miss in a bad way.
A mnohokrát veríme možno zlým spôsobom.
A wrong belief.
Máme takú zlú vieru, zlé presvedčenie.
That God is stingy.
Že Pán Boh je držgroš.
That he's got everything and he's just kind of holding back.
Že on všetko má, ale si to tak zadrža, nechce nám to dať.
Jesus cleared it all up.
Ale Pán Ježiš to objasnil.
Says you don't have because you don't ask.
Nemáte, lebo si nepýtate.
And God's had to convict me many times about that.
A Pán Boh musel aj mňa usvedčiť mnohokrát z tohto.
Where I'm feeling like I don't have what I need.
Lebo ja si myslím, že ja nemám to, čo potrebujem.
And then he reminds me, have you asked me?
A potom on mi musí pripomenúť, že a pýtal si si to?
Then I get real sheepish.
A potom som taký ovečkársky.
Oh yeah.
Aha.
You're right, I forgot.
Zabudol som si to poprosiť.
Forgot to invite you in this situation.
Zabudol som ťa, Pane Bože, pozvať do tejto situácie.
And I found out personally, especially my whole life here in Slovakia, is God's a gracious, generous giver.
A celý môj život, hlavne tu na Slovensku, som zistil, že Pán Boh je milosrdný a štedrý darca.
Paul the apostle has this experience and he tells it to the church in Philippi.
A Pavol apoštol má tiež takýto zážitok a hovorí to zboru vo Filipis.
He says, you know, I've learned to be content in all circumstances.
A hovorím, že naučil som sa uskromniť alebo žiť vo všetkých rôznych situáciách.
Says in every situation.
V každej jednej situácii, či už dobrej alebo zlej,
well fed, not so well fed.
Či už som nasýtený alebo som hladný,
with excess and what feels like lack.
A či už mám prebytok veci alebo mám nedostatok.
Says, I can do all things.
A hovorí, že ja môžem robiť všetky veci alebo všetko dokážem
through him, through Jesus,
skrze Neho, skrze Pána Ježiša, ktorý mi dáva silu,
Jesus,
ktorý ma posilňuje.
Jesus said it this way.
Pán Ježiš to povedal takto.
When he was given the Sermon on the Mount.
Keď kázal na vrchu.
He says, you know, don't worry about what tomorrow brings.
Nestrachujte sa, čo vám donesie zajtrajšok.
We do a lot of worrying about tomorrow, right?
My sa častokrát strachujeme o tom zajtrajšku.
Says, don't worry.
Nestrachuj sa.
Don't worry what you're going to wear.
Nestrachujte sa, čo si oblečiete.
Don't worry what you're going to eat.
Čo budete jesť.
Don't worry about those things.
Nestrachujte sa ohľadom týchto
Your
vecí.
Father in heaven, he knows.
Tvoj nebeský Otec vie o všetkých týchto
He's
veciach.
He's taking care of the little birds.
On sa stará aj o vtáčiky.
He takes care of them, he can take care of you.
A ak sa postará o nich, tak sa postará aj o teba.
And it's a great passage to look at. It's Matthew 5 and 6.
Môžete si to pozrieť. Je to v Matúšovi 5. a 6. kapitola.
If you feel yourself worrying about things, you don't feel like you have enough, go to those verses, read them. Let them sink into your heart.
A ak sa strachujete niekedy o čokoľvek vo vašom živote, tak sa vráťte k tejto pasáži a prečítajte si to, je to veľmi pozbudzujúce.
He goes on
and a potom pokračuje a hovorí.
He says he leads me, God leads me to lie down in green pastures and he leads me beside quiet waters.
Na pastvách zelených ma pasie a k vodám osviežujúcim ma privádza.
One thing is sheep are prone to do a lot of things, so they're prone to wander.
Čiže ovečky robia veľa vecí. Jedna z tých vecí je, že odchádzajú alebo sa túlajú.
But they like to eat and they like to drink.
Ale radi jedia a radi pijú.
But the problem is that sometimes they eat and drink in the wrong places.
Ale niekedy jedia a pijú na zlých pastvinách.
In the wrong proportions.
A zlé množstva.
And sometimes the wrong paces or time.
A niekedy zlou rýchlosťou alebo zlým časom.
And God is kind of leading David to take in what he needs in all the right times and all the right places.
A Pán Boh zobral Davida, aby dostal všetko to, čo potrebuje v správny čas a na správnom mieste.
And I like what it says. It says, he makes me lie down in green pastures.
A v angličtine je povedané, že on ma dotlačí, aby som si ľahol na tie správne pastviny.
So he takes me to a good place and he makes me to be there.
On ma zoberie na to miesto a nechá ma tam, aby som tam bol.
David saying he forces me to do something I wouldn't normally do.
On ma prinúti, aby som spravil niečo, čo by som normálne nerobil.
And sometimes God does that for us.
A niekedy to Pán Boh robí aj pre nás.
He leads us and he makes us do something that doesn't come natural.
On nás zoberie, dovedie nás do niečoho, aby sme niečo spravili, čo nie je prirodzené pre nás.
But we need it.
Ale my to potrebujeme.
And it's good for us.
A je to dobre pre nás.
And you know, we might be seeking certain things to meet our needs in places that we don't need to be seeking.
A hľadáme nejaké veci, aby zabezpečili tie naše potreby alebo naše túžby, ktoré máme, a hľadáme na zlých miestach.
You know, sometimes we look for things in all the wrong places.
Niekedy hľadáme na všetkých tých zlých miestach, kde by sme nemali.
God saying, be right here.
Ale Pán Boh nám povie, nie, tu si teraz.
This might not be what comes natural.
Nie je to niečo, čo je prirodzené pre nás.
Just be here. This is good for you.
Ale Pán Boh nám hovorí, tu si teraz, zostaň tu, je to dobré pre teba.
Says he leads him.
A je tam napísané, že ma vedie.
Leads him beside the quiet waters.
Vedie ma k vodám tichým.
Takes him to that place where it's safe for him to drink.
Je to miesto, kde je bezpečné pre ňoho, aby pil.
You know, where it's calm and there's comfort.
Kde je tichosť a kde je taká, také utešenie.
You know, so many people.
Tak veľa ľudí.
In our city and maybe even sometimes us.
Či už v našom meste, alebo možno aj my sami.
Running around trying to meet those daily needs.
Sa proste naháňajú, aby sa postarali o tie každodenné potreby.
And we meet those needs.
A potom keď sa o ne postaráme,
but we meet them at a cost.
Tak sa postaráme o ne s tým, že musíme zaplatiť určitú cenu.
We meet our needs in all the wrong places.
A postaráme sa o nich zlým spôsobom.
We meet those physical needs.
Tie fyzické potreby zabezpečíme.
Meet those emotional needs.
Emočné potreby.
We meet our spiritual needs.
Duchovné potreby.
But on in all the wrong places.
Ale vždycky je to na tom nesprávnom mieste.
And God said, this is where you need to be.
Ale Pán Boh nám hovorí, toto je miesto, kde máš byť.
He goes on.
A potom pokračuje.
And David says, through all this, God, he refreshes my soul.
A cez všetko toto David hovorí, že je to Hospodin, ktorý mu občerstvuje dušu.
Or he restores my soul.
Alebo mi ju obživuje.
Sometimes the soul is a kind of difficult thing to specify.
A duša je niekedy ťažká, aby sme ju špecifikovali.
You know, there's different words in the Bible. Sometimes it says heart, sometimes it says spirit, sometimes it says soul.
V Biblii máme rôzne slova, či už je to srdce, či už je to duša alebo duch človeka.
Sometimes it says mind.
Niekedy myseľ.
You know, I heard one simple definition though.
Ja som počul jednu veľmi jednoduchú definíciu.
Your soul is the part of you that is you, like really you, you know?
Tá tvoja duša je to, čo z teba robí teba.
It's that part that's completely unique.
Je to tá časť teba, ktorá je úplne jedinečná.
Where you are able to relate to others and relate to God.
Kde ty si schopný mať vzťah s inými a mať vzťah s Bohom.
It's the core of you.
Je to to tvoje jadro.
It's the part that remains when your body does not.
Je to tá časť, čo zostáva, aj keď už tvoje telo netrvá.
And it says God restores the core of us.
Čiže je to Hospodin, ktorý občerstvuje túto našu dušu, alebo ju obživuje.
This word refresh or restore literally means to bring back.
Občerstviť, obživiť je niečo, že prinesiete naspäť niečo.
It's like to bring back to the original place.
Naspäť do toho správneho, prvotného štádia.
It's like to hit the restart button.
Ako na počítači, keď máte ten gombík reštartu.
Or if you're driving your car and you're using the GPS.
Alebo šoferujete auto a máte zapnutú navigáciu.
You get on the wrong path, right?
A ste na zlej cestičke.
And you hear this woman's voice saying, recalibrate.
Recalculating.
Recalculating.
A potom ako ste na tej zlej cestičke, tak počujete tú žensku, ktorá vám tam hovorí, prepočítavame a prenavigujeme vás.
Okay.
Dobre, okay.
You're getting back to where you're supposed to be.
Vraciaš sa naspäť tam, kde si mal pôvodne byť.
Another translation for this word is repent.
A iný preklad tohto slovička je kajať sa.
And that's really what repentance is.
A o tom to je pokánie.
It's your soul getting back to home.
Kde tvoja duša sa vráti naspäť domov.
Where it belongs.
Tam, kde patrí.
In the right place.
Do toho správneho miesta.
The apostle Peter will speak about this in his letter to the churches in 1 Peter chapter 2.
Apoštol Peter o tomto písal zborom vo svojom liste, v prvom liste Petra, 2. kapitola.
Verse
25. Verš.
It says, "We are like sheep gone astray."
My sme ako ovečky zblúdili.
But you've now returned to the shepherd and overseers of your soul.
Ale teraz ste sa vrátili ku svojmu pastierovi a milovníkovi vašich duší.
How is this all done?
Ako sa to deje?
Well, Peter tells us in the previous verse, verse 24.
A Peter nám to hovorí v 24. verši.
He says, he himself, Jesus, has borne our sins.
On sám, Pán Ježiš, niesol naše hriechy.
By his body on the cross.
A vyniesol tie hriechy na kríž vo svojom tele.
So that we might die to sin and live for righteousness.
Aby my sme odumreli hriechu a žili spravodlivosti.
By his wounds you have been healed.
A jeho ranami sa nám dostalo uzdravenia.
You've been refreshed.
Sme občerstvení.
You've been restored.
Obnovení.
I love this set of verses. It's also from Peter.
A mne sa páčia tieto verše tiež z Petra.
It's in the book of Acts.
V Skutkoch.
The Holy Spirit has come down on him and the others.
Alebo teda od Petra vyšli tieto verše, keď Duch Svätý zostúpil na neho a na iných.
And he kinda gets it.
A vtedy mu to došlo.
And he gets out on the street.
A vystúpil na ulici.
And all this huge crowd starts to ask him, what are you doing?
A všetky tie zástupy sa ho pýtali, že čo robíš?
And he begins to speak about Jesus.
A začal im hovoriť o Pánovi Ježišovi.
And he's telling this group of people, he says, repent.
A tej skupine ľudí hovorí, že kajajte sa.
Come back, come home.
Vráťte sa naspäť domov.
He says, turn to God. This is in Acts 3.
A obráťte sa k Bohu v Skutkoch, 3. kapitole.
So that your sins will be wiped out.
Aby vám boli zahladené vaše hriechy.
And pay attention to this part.
A dávajte pozor na túto ďalšiu časť.
And times of refreshing will come from the Lord.
A aby vám nastal čas občerstvenia od Pána.
And that's what happens as we come back to home, sit in those green pastures that he puts us in that don't necessarily come natural.
A keď sedíme na tých zelených pastvách, kde by sme prirodzene sami sa nedostali,
we get refreshed.
Tak vtedy dostávame občerstvenie.
Things are good.
Veci sú dobré.
He goes on.
Pokračuje ďalej.
God doesn't just take us to the green pastures and say, here, sit here and just get fat.
Pán Boh nám nehovorí, že áno, tu máš zelené pastviny, tu si pekne setkaj a buď tučnučky.
The journey's not over.
A púť sa neskončila.
He leads us on.
Ale vedie nás ďalej.
It says he guides me along right paths for his namesake.
Po spravodlivých cestách vodí ma pre svoje meno.
He tells us where, says where he leads and why he leads.
Čiže hovorí nám, že kam nás vedie a prečo nás tam vedie.
Well, that's not exactly true.
Ale síce nie je to pravda.
He doesn't exactly tell where he's leading.
Nepovie nám ani, že kam nás vedie.
But he says the kind of path he's leading us on.
Ale hovorí nám, že po akej ceste nás vedie.
It's the right one.
Je to tá správna cesta.
It's the straight path.
Je to tá rovná cesta.
And I've experienced that many times with God.
A mnohokrát ja som toto zakúsil s Bohom.
Walking with him.
Keď s ním kráčam.
Where the Spirit will tell me to do something or speak to someone.
Kde Duch mi povie, že mám sa porozprávať s niekým alebo s niekým sa stretnúť.
Or make a decision.
Alebo mám spraviť nejaké rozhodnutie.
And it may not feel comfortable and it may not feel what I'm used to.
A možno sa necítim ani tak v pohode, že takéto rozhodnutie mám spraviť, ani nie som zvyknutý takéto rozhodnutia robiť.
But I know the path.
Ale poznám tú cestu.
But I don't know where it leads necessarily.
Ale nie vždy viem, kam ma dovedie tá cesta.
But like a sheep, I know that he's walking in front of me.
Ale ako ovečka viem, že on ako pastier kráča predo mnou.
The sheep really don't need to know where they're going, they just need to know where the shepherd is.
A ovečky nepotrebujú vedieť, kam kráčajú, potrebujú vidieť, kam kráča pastier.
And Jesus said really clearly.
Pán Ježiš povedal veľmi jasne.
He said, I am the way.
Že ja som cesta.
I'm the truth.
Ja som pravda.
I'm the life.
Ja som život.
We keep that in mind.
Ak budeme mať toto na mysli,
we don't have to worry necessarily where we're going.
Nemusíme sa strachovať, že kam presne ideme.
As long as we're going with him.
Ak kráčame s ním.
But he also gives us the why.
Ale hovorí nám aj, že prečo.
It says for his namesake.
Kvôli svojmu menu.
And for me that's very encouraging.
A toto pre mňa je veľmi pozbudzujúce.
Because basically what David is saying.
Lebo čo tu Dávid hovorí.
Says God leads me in the right way.
Je, že Pán Boh ma vedie tým správnym smerom
for his own reputation.
Kvôli svojmu vlastnému menu alebo reputácii, známosti.
God's reputation rests on him guiding me well.
Božia známosť záleží od toho, že on ma bude viesť správnym smerom.
Somehow in all that he gets fame and glory.
Nejakým spôsobom z toho celého on dostane slávu a česť.
He gets some fame.
On bude mať z toho nejakú slávu.
So he's kind of invested in that process.
Čiže on sa investoval do toho celého procesu.
It means something to him.
Niečo to pre neho znamená.
Probably means a whole lot more to him than it means to me.
Asi to pre neho znamená o mnoho viacej, ako to znamená pre mňa.
And just know, you're his prized possession.
A nezabúdajte, že ste jeho cenným vlastníctvom.
You're his, the apple of his eye.
Vy ste zrenicou jeho oka.
You know, he's not going to let you fall.
Nedovolí ti, aby si padol.
He's actually invested in you.
On sa do teba investoval.
And it goes on. We see a little bit where he leads us or how he leads us.
A potom, keď pokračuje, tak uvidíme, že kam a ako nás vedie.
And I think this part of the verses have really comforted people over the years.
A myslím si, že tieto verše potešovali mnoho ľudí tie roky.
Says, even though I walk through the darkest valley.
Keby som kráčal hoci temným údolím.
Some translations say through the valley of the shadow of death. It's very dramatic. I like it.
Niektoré preklady hovoria, keby som kráčal aj údolím smrti.
I will fear no evil.
Tak sa nebojím zlého.
For you're with me.
Lebo ty si so mnou.
Who is leading David at this point?
Kto vedie Dávida v tejto chvíli?
In the darkness.
V temnote.
God is.
Boh ho vedie.
Right? David's not alone. There.
David tam nie je sám.
But if you've ever been in the forest,
ak ste boli niekedy v lese,
especially in the dark,
hlavne keď je tma,
and you've been in the valley,
a boli ste v údolí,
kind of like this, you know, just all these dark pine trees, I think Tatra is somewhere like that.
A tmavé lesy, borovicové alebo akékoľvek tmavé miesto v lese.
You're in the narrow valley and you're pretty vulnerable.
A vy keď sa nachádzate v tom údolí, tak ste dosť zraniteľní.
You can't really go anywhere easily.
Nemôžete sa nikam dostať.
It's a perfect place for an ambush. That's why they do it there all the time.
Je to dokonalé miesto, aby vás niekto obklúčil, a väčšinou to tak robievali.
And it's kind of spooky going through the woods at night.
A je to dosť také vystrašujúce, keď máte v noci ísť v lese.
You know, and life feels that way at times, right?
A niekedy aj život sa tak cíti, alebo sa cítime v živote takto.
You're in this dark place.
Nachádzate sa v takom temnom období.
Might feel evil, might feel even like death.
Možno sa cítite zle a možno sa cítite ako keby už blízko smrti.
You got nowhere to go.
Nemáte žiadne východisko, alebo kam by ste sa mohli dostať.
And that's where David felt like he was in sometimes, that's maybe where you, where I feel.
Takže David sa možno cítil niekedy takto, možno ty sa takto cítiš, možno ja sa niekedy takto cítim.
But what's encouraging for me is the valley of darkness is not the destination.
Ale čo je pre mňa povzbudzujúce je to, že toto údolie nie je našim cieľovým bodom.
God was guiding David through it, not to it.
A Pán Boh viedol Dávida skrze toto údolie, nie do tohto údolia.
Why does the shepherd, why does anyone go through the valley when they're in the mountains?
Prečo by ktokoľvek išiel nejakým údolím, keď sú v lese?
Well, basically the shepherd, he'll lead, it's the easiest path for one.
Je to väčšinou najjednoduchšia cestička.
To get to the higher pastures.
Aby ste sa dostali na tie lepšie pastviny.
And then later when winter comes, to get down to the lower pastures.
A niekedy, a potom keď príde zima, tak aby ste zišli na do tých nižších častí.
To basically get home.
Aby ste sa vrátili domov.
And sometimes the way home is through the darkness.
A niekedy aj cesta domov vedie cez tieto tmavé kútiky.
And we don't see David crying to God saying, "Take away the darkness."
Nevidíme, že David by tu volal, že Pane Bože, sním túto temnotu.
We don't see the shepherd guiding him around along the tops of the hills or anything.
Ani nevidíme, že by to bol pastier a iba po vrcholcoch ich viedol.
He carries him through.
Ale prešli cez to.
I came across this quote, it says, "We want Christ to hurry and calm the storm."
A našiel som jeden taký citát, ktorý hovorí, že chceme, aby prišiel Kristus, aby sa poponáhľal a utišil búrku.
But he wants us to find him in the midst of it first.
Ale on chce, aby sme ho našli v strede tej búrky najskôr.
That's what happened to Jesus and his 12, right?
To sa stalo aj s učeníkmi a s pánom Ježišom.
They're in a storm on the Lake of Galilee.
Boli v búrke na Galilejskom mori.
Jesus is taking a little nap.
A pán Ježiš si tam zdriemol.
They wake up freaking out, or they're freaking out and they wake him up.
A oni panikárili a zobudili ho.
They say, "Wake up!
Zobuď sa!
Don't you care for us?
Nezáleží ti na nás?"
You know, he says, "Yeah."
Áno, záleží.
What are you worried about? Don't be afraid.
Čo sa strachujete? Nemusíte sa báť.
And he speaks to the wind and the waves.
A prehovorí k vetru a k vlnám.
And everything chills out.
A všetko sa utíši.
And they chill out.
A oni sa utíšia.
And then they realize who's in the boat with them.
A potom si uvedomia, že kto bol s nimi v tej lodi.
They begin to worship him.
A začali ho uctievať.
They got it for a moment.
A na chvíľku im to došlo.
And many times we're just freaking out, right?
A niekedy aj my proste panikárime.
Don't you care?
Pane Bože, nezáleží ti?
God cares.
Áno, Pánu Bohu záleží.
Jesus knew what was going on.
Pán Ježiš vedel, čo sa dialo.
You never see in the story that Jesus was worried.
Nikdy v tom príbehu nevidíme, že by sa Pán Ježiš strachoval.
He had it under control.
Mal to všetko pod kontrolou.
He was just waiting.
On len čakal.
Waiting for them to ask.
Čakal, kedy ho poprosia.
To turn on the light.
Aby zasvietili.
To invite him.
Aby ho pozvali.
I'm gonna go on. So David doesn't stay in the valley, he moves forward through the valley.
Čiže David nezostáva v tom údolí, ale prechádza cez to údolie.
There's nothing to fear.
Ničoho sa nemusíme báť.
Because God was with him.
Lebo Hospodin je s nami, bol s ním.
He goes on and says, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
Tvoj prúd a tvoja palica ma potešujú.
Just really quick, the rod and the staff, they may be two instruments, or some people think they're one thing, but you can just think of a big stick.
Niektorí si myslia, že možno prúd a palica boli dve veci, ale niektorí zase si myslia, že to bola jedna vec. My si môžeme to zobrať ako veľkú takú palicu.
Basically used for two things.
A používala sa na dve veci.
To protect the sheep.
Ochrániť ovečky.
So beat the wolves or whatever.
Vlkov zbiť, alebo ktokoľvek iný by prišiel.
And also to discipline the sheep.
Ale takisto aj tie ovečky vychovať.
You know, beat the sheep, hey, get back over here.
Že poď sem, vráť sa naspäť.
And David says he takes comfort in that.
A David sa z toho tešil. Potešovalo ho to.
He knows that God's going to protect him, but he's also going to discipline him.
On vedel, že Pán Boh ho bude chrániť, ale bude ho aj vychovávať.
We don't really have time for it, but if you look up in Hebrews chapter 6, I think it is.
Nemáme síce na toto čas, ale keby ste si pozreli Židom 6. kapitola.
There's this whole chapter about how the writer saying, "Hey guys, when you have things happening to you, difficult things."
A kde písateľ hovorí, že ak sa vám dejú takéto ťažkosti,
you have discipline happening in your life.
Tak máte takú výchovu, ktorá sa odohráva vo vašom živote.
Don't cry about it.
Neplačte alebo nestiažujte
Rejoice
sa.
In it.
Ale tešte sa z toho.
Because God is treating you as sons and daughters.
Lebo Pán Boh k vám pristupuje ako k synom a dcerám.
He says, take it as a good thing.
A zoberte to ako dobrú vec.
That God is actually looking out for you.
Že Pán Boh sa o teba stará.
And he wants to shape you and grow you in a particular way.
A chce ťa sformovať, a chce, aby si vyrástol určitým spôsobom.
He doesn't want you to be feral or just kind of just wild children just run off and wandering too far.
On nechce, aby ste boli divoké deti, ktoré sa rozbehnú kade tade a budú si robiť čo chcú.
He wants to grow you to be mature.
Ale chce, aby ste vyrástli, aby ste boli dospelí.
And he'll go on in his song.
A pokračuje vo svojom žalme.
This is great. He says, I will prepare you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Just have this imagination of this like royal picnic out in the field.
Ja si predstavujem taký kráľovský piknik niekde na poli.
You know, lots of food, good stuff.
Veľa jedla, všetko dobré.
And on the edges the forest, the dark forest.
A na kraji je ten tmavý les.
And you can hear the wolves howling. Right?
A počujete tých vlkov, ako tam zavíjajú.
And you're eating a big steak.
A vy si tam jete veľký rezeň.
Having a second piece of cake.
A máte druhú porciu koláča.
Having a feast.
A jete a vychutnávate
and
si to.
And the wolves are howling.
A tí vlci zavíjajú.
And that's what the picture David is presenting, you know.
Toto je ten obraz, ktorý nám Dávid dáva.
God's going to prepare this amazing feast, this blessing, despite that the wolves are howling around.
Pán Boh ti pripraví úžasné požehnanie aj napriek tomu, že tí vlci niekde zavíjajú.
And we already saw that last week, every attack that Saul had on David, God twists and turns into a blessing.
Každý ten útok, ktorý prišiel Davidovi od Saula, Pán Boh zmenil a zmenil to na požehnanie.
He turns it into success and into a feast.
A zmenil to na úspech a na hodovanie.
And we have the same thing.
A my máme to isté.
You know, if Jesus is in you.
Ak Pán Ježiš je v tebe.
You know, he is a light that shines in the darkness and the darkness cannot overcome.
On je tým svetlom, ktoré svieti v tme a tá tma ho nedokáže pohltiť.
And if he's in you, he can do that same thing.
A ak on je v tebe, on dokáže to isté skrze teba robiť.
I'm going to use Ivetka as an example. She probably don't want me to.
Thanks. Použijem Ivetku ako príklad.
You know, but this year it's... I've mentioned this to a few of you. This year Ivetka got stuck with a lot of ethics class at our school.
Už som vám to hovoril niektorým z vás. Tento rok Ivetke pridelili etiku učiť.
And ethics is not really like the most favored classes at our school.
A etika nie je ten obľúbený predmet u nás na škole?
You know, and oftentimes they're a terrible lesson to teach because the kids don't really want to be there.
A je to taká najhoršia hodina, ktorú môžete učiť, lebo ani decka tam nechcú byť.
Especially if you're working with high schoolers.
A hlavne ak pracujete s gymnazistami.
And she kind of got stuck with some of these classes and I think there were some wolves that were howling.
A jej sa pridelili tieto hodiny, lebo si myslím, že boli určití vlci, ktorí niekde zavíjali.
And you know, at the beginning of the year we just prayed together.
A na začiatku sme sa modlili spolu.
And so you know this is where God's put you.
Áno, Pán Boh ťa dal do tejto situácie.
So just give it to him.
Tak to vráť naspäť jemu.
And she's been doing that.
A ona toto robila.
And it's been so cool every week.
A každý týždeň bolo to také super.
Her coming and sharing with me what God is doing in her and through her on the ethics lessons.
Čo Pán Boh robí v nej a skrze ňu na týchto hodinách etiky.
Because we got a lot of kids who are, you know, they're lost spiritually.
Lebo máme veľa detí, ktoré sú stratené duchovne.
They've got a lot of hurts.
Majú veľa zranenia.
A lot of family issues.
Veľa rodinných problémov.
They got maybe they have neglect of wealth in the sense that they've got so much sometimes that it's not good for them.
Majú tak veľa bohatstva, že to až pre nich nie je dobré.
And there's a lot of pain.
A je tam veľa utrpenia, bolesti.
And it's so cool the things that are coming out in these ethics lessons where they're just sharing their heart and coming to Ivetka and some small steps of healing.
A je to také úžasné vidieť, ako skrze tieto hodiny môže prichádzať aj uzdravenie.
And you know, God's put her in that place.
A Pán Boh ju dal do tohto miesta.
It was the green pasture she would never sat down in.
A bolo toto zelené, tá zelená pastvina, kde by si sama nebola sadla.
And there are some wolves howling, you know.
A síce tí vlci zavíjajú.
But God's turning it into a feast.
Ale Pán Boh to mení na oslavu.
It's a good thing.
A je to dobrá vec.
And David says here, he anoints my head with oil.
David nám tu hovorí, že je to Pán Boh, ktorý mu pomazáva hlavu olejom.
When the shepherd would do that, it would be against like pests and bugs and things like that.
Keď toto robil pastier ovečkám, tak by to bolo na ochranu tých ovečiek pred rôznymi chrobákmi.
It served kind of like a medicine.
Bolo to ako keby liek.
But in scriptures we know that this anointing with oil always is this picture of the Holy Spirit.
Ale z písma tiež vieme, že pomazanie olejom je obraz Ducha Svätého.
And God's very consistent with his metaphors.
A Pán Boh je vždycky taký pevný s tými svojimi metaforami.
He says here, my cup overflows.
Lebo tu hovorí, že preteká môj pohár, môj kalich.
And Jesus spoke when he spoke of us receiving the Holy Spirit.
A Pán Ježiš, keď hovoril o nás, ako budeme príjmať Ducha Svätého.
He says it's like a river of living water in you.
A tak hovorí, že on bude tou riekou živej vody, ktorá bude prekypovať
like
z nás.
Like a stream.
Ako potok.
Actually a spring where the
alebo žriedlo.
The beginning of a stream, yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's bubbling up and it's overflowing.
A to žriedlo tak prekypuje a preteká.
It doesn't just fill one zone, but it goes and it overflows and becomes a river.
A nenapĺňa to len jednu nejakú oblasť, ale preteká to a naplňa všetko naokolo.
And that's supposed to be your life, that's supposed to be my life.
A toto má byť tvojim životom, môjim životom.
That Jesus would come in.
Že Pán Ježiš, keď príde k nám,
his spirit would come in us.
Jeho duch, keď na nás zostupí,
and we'd be blessed, we'd enjoy the feast.
A my, ako sme požehnaní a vychutnávame si tú hostinu,
but it would spill out and touch others.
Tak aby sa to rozlievalo ďalej a dotýkalo ostatných.
And then the last verse 6.
A posledný, šiestý verš.
It says, surely your goodness and love, and some translations say mercy, will follow me all the days of my life.
Len dobrota a milosť, alebo niektoré preklady hovoria láska, bude ma sprevádzať po všetky dni môjho života.
And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
A bývať budem v dome Hospodinovom na veky, alebo na dlhé časy.
Goodness and mercy.
Dobrota a milosť.
Beauty.
Úžasnosť.
Love.
Krása. Láska.
You know, all these things would follow David.
Všetky tieto veci nasledovali Dávida.
For all the days of his life.
Každý jeden deň jeho života.
He would dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
prebýval v Božom dome na veky.
Paul will write to the church in Rome.
A Pavol napísal zboru v Ríme.
Another one of those good homework chapters to check out, Romans chapter 8.
Čiže zase domáca úloha rímskym, 8. kapitola, ak si chcete doma prečítať.
He says about you and me.
Toto hovorí o mne a o tebe.
We're more than conquerors. We're victorious through him who loves us.
Sme viac ako víťazi, sme zvíťazili skrze Pána Ježiša.
He says there's nothing.
A nie je nič.
Death.
Ani smrť.
Angels.
Anieli.
Demons.
Démoni.
Things from the present.
Veci prítomné.
Things from the past, things from the future.
Veci minulé, veci z budúcnosti.
There's nothing, no height, no depth, nothing.
Ani vysokosť, ani nízkosť, nič.
Nothing in all of creation.
Nič v celom stvorenstve.
That can separate you from the love of God.
Nás nedokáže odlúčiť od lásky Kristovej, od lásky Božej.
That is experience in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Ktorú zakúšame v Pánovi Ježišovi Kristovi, našom Pánovi.
David knew that in a way.
Dávid toto poznal určitým spôsobom.
There was nothing that Saul could throw at him.
Nebolo nič, čo by mu Saul vedel predložiť.
That could separate him from his shepherd.
Čo by ho mohlo oddeliť od jeho pastiera.
There was no darkness from Saul that could overshadow the light of the shepherd.
Nebola žiadna temnota od Saula, ktorá by mohla zakryť to svetlo, ktoré Dávid mal v Bohu.
All these things were David's heart.
Všetky tieto veci boli Dávidovi na srdci.
For God and God's heart for David.
Alebo bolo to Dávidovým srdcom, Dávidovou túžbou po Bohu a Božia túžba po Dávidovi.
My encouragement and challenge for you.
A mojim pozbudením a výzvou pre vás
is, will it be our heart?
Bude to našim srdcom,
will
našou túžbou?
Will be my heart?
Bude to na mojom srdci?
Will I have this kind of song on my lips this week?
Bude mať aj ja takúto pieseň na mojich perách tento týždeň?
I have a lot of songs running through my head on my lips, but it's not usually this one.
Ja mám veľa piesní, ktoré sa mi premielajú mysľou, ale väčšinou to nie je táto.
But it should be this one.
Ale malo by to byť toto.
It should be the anthem.
Malo by to byť našou hymnou.
So what we're going to do is we're going to have one or two more songs of worship.
Budeme mať ešte ďalšie chvály.
I would encourage you.
A chcel by som vás pozbudiť.
If there's something that we spoke about today that you say, yeah, I want more of that.
Ak sme o niečo hovorili a dotklo sa vás to a ste si povedali, že áno, chcel by som viacej z tohto v mojom živote.
Then just ask.
Tak si to popros.
Ask the Lord.
Poprosi si to od Hospodina.
You don't have it because you're not asking.
A nemáš to, lebo si to nežiadaš.
And he'll be faithful and generous to give.
A on bude verný a štedrý, aby ti to dal.
And if you want anyone to pray for you, I'll be happy to pray with you. I'm sure anyone around here.
A ak potrebujete modlitby, tak ja som ochotný sa s vami modliť, alebo hoci kto je tu, sa
we'll
môžete modliť spolu.
Stand with you in that.
A budeme za vami stáť v tom, čo si žiadate.
So.